All right, yo, Thug Life. All right, okay, anyway, welcome back to Pokemon Stadium, part 30. Holy shit, 30 episodes, that's incredible. Anyway, so we get a music change here, and yeah, we're up to the Elite Four already in the Gym Leader Castle, so let's go ahead and take these guys on. All three of them, all four of them have the same title there of Elite Four Trainer. So let's go. Take the same registered team like we always do. This is the Blue Kaizo team. You can go check that video out. It's somewhere in my uploaded videos. I think the first episode to that is linked in the first episode of this particular thing. Anyway, Lorelei this time around, not just rocking all the ice types and water types and shit. She has got a Wigglytuff and an Exeggutor. She's also chilling with a Starmie there, so she's got a couple psychic types as well as, of course, Articuno. So that could be a problem later. We'll have to see. But anyway, we're going to go with this, and I am going to bring this just for that Exeggutor, because ain't nobody like Exeggutor. So here we go, Lorelei, and she's going to lead with her best Pokemon, Articuno. So of course, having Solomon in here, that's going to be good for us, because that means we can T-Bolt the shit out of that thing. And that's going to do a huge amount of damage, more than half, and it will go down on this next turn. Lorelei employs the same strategy that she does in round one. She is actually going to be trying to Toxic Stall your Pokemon down. Luckily, that shit isn't going to work here, as we will bring down the legendary Articuno in just two hits. One of the best cries in the game goes down. Anyway, just like that, we are already one Pokemon down, and 11 to go, and we're done with the Elite Four. Anyway, here comes Exeggutor, and that is not something I wanted to see right now, because, again, Solomon does not have anything that it can do to this thing. But I'm going to T-Wave it, and we're going to see how this goes. I'm going to take some poison damage, and it's going to go for the Leech Seed. So that works out well, because that's pretty much a free Thunder Wave on that thing, because I am going to switch out this turn, so that guy is just not looking good. So we send out Derry. Derry's ready to go with his Exeggutor, but Exeggutor isn't messing around. It's going to go straight for the Psychic, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage. It's not even super effective, and then it does a buttload of damage, nearly, I think that's a 3-hit KO from that range. We're going to go for the Fire Blast, and we are straight up going to miss that attack, so you see right now the hack's already beginning. And that is definitely a solid 3-hit KO on Derry, and I'm really hoping that this Fire Blast hits, because if it doesn't, I'm going to be in trouble. Luckily, it does, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage, nearly bringing it down to half. Well, it did bring it down to half, but anyway, he is not getting paralyzed, and he's going to take down Arcanine in three hits, and this Exeggutor is still looking strong. I do have Pope in the wing, though. So Aerodactyl ready to go, and we're going to fly up into the air. And we should be able to finish this thing off with a fly. He's finally paralyzed when, of course, it literally doesn't matter. That's usually how these things go. Anyway, here comes the fly, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage, and it will bring it down. So she's now down to her last Pokemon. And it's going to be Almastar. Luckily, I can get an Earthquake off here. And in fact, Pope might go down to one Hydro Pump. And that Earthquake is not even going to be a 3-hit KO, and we'll see if I can live this Hydro Pump. That's going to do a huge amount of damage, and that actually is going to bring down Pope in one hit. So that's a problem. Almastar obviously has very good defense, as well as very good special. Our last Pokemon is Solomon. And unfortunately, he is poisoned, so that could prove to be a problem in this battle. But we'll see. I'm pretty sure this will bring it down from that health range. And in fact, it does. So, just like that, we're done with the first trainer of the Elite Four. And I'm not going to scumbag this like I did on the Blue Kaizo. I'm going to do all of the Elite Four in this one video, so obviously you can tell that since this video's like 20 minutes long. Let's move on to the easiest of the trainers, Bruno. But Bruno not messing around this time. He's bringing a Slowbro as well as a Clefable there. He's also got Muk, so we'll see how that goes. I'm thinking here that my best lead is going to be this guy. And I think I'll also bring this guy and probably this guy too. So, yeah. That should work. So we're going to leave with Billy, just because Billy has pretty much perfect coverage on everything. He's going to leave with Rhydon. Rhydon there with nearly 400 HP. Rhydon, though, is super slow, but even though it is super slow, it is faster than Slowbro, and it's going to be able to hit me with an Earthquake, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage. Remember, Billy has huge defenses, but it still takes a buttload of damage from that Earthquake. But not even Bruno's Rhydon is going to be able to survive a Surf. There's just no way. It needs Solid Rock, which it doesn't get until like four generations from now. Anyway, he goes into his own Slowbro. And that's cool, whatevs, do what I want. So we're going to go for the Amnesia this time around here, because I figure... Well, it's just going to go for Surf. It's probably not the best play on his part, but whatever. It definitely did not do much damage, and now I'm going to take this opportunity to go for another Amnesia. And it's still going to go for Surf, and that is literally not going to do anything. That'll do like 5 damage. Yeah, it does like 15 damage, so that is just not looking good for this guy. And I am going to start going for the Psychics now. And we'll see if we can get to work on bringing this thing down. So that's... Jesus, that's not even going to bring it down. That sucks. However, a Surf might be able to bring it down. But either way, I'm going to go for an Amnesia this turn so I can guarantee to bring it down on the next turn. And this way I get a little bit more defense and should be set up for the last Pokemon, whatever it is. As long as I can survive one hit. But if I can survive a Rhydon's Earthquake by not even taking a third of my health, I should be okay. Anyway, now that Billy's special is 999, there's no way this thing is going to live that. The type disadvantage has no effect at all. Unfortunately, its last Pokemon is Clefable. And here comes Body Slam. And I'm going to be able to take a bunch of those if I have to. But I don't think I'm going to have to. I think this will finish it off. As that's going to deal a huge amount of damage. And there is just no way, after 3 Amnesias, Billy's special is maxed out. So Billy able to deal with Bruno with a lot of ease, actually. Bruno, not the smartest of the Elite Four, allowing me to set up the Amnesias against his Slowbro. He really should have done something about that. Oh well, whatever, I'm not going to complain. So here we go against Agatha. Now Agatha, she's rocking 3 poison types here, but she's also got an Alakazam and a Jinx and a Gyarados. This could be a tough battle. I'm not looking forward to this one. I think, realistically, you're going to be the best lead. I think I'll also bring you and so it looks like I make the right choice for a lead Pokemon, as she is leading with Jinx, and I'm leading with Arcanine, and Arcanine is pretty much going to be able to destroy this thing. We will hit that fire blast, hopefully, and of course we do, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage, nearly bringing it down in one hit. Here comes a psychic blast, though, and that is going to lower my special, and that is not good. I will be able to take this thing out with a double edge to the face. And Jinx is going to collapse and disappear there. Agatha's next Pokemon is going to be Arbok. Probably the weakest of her Pokemon. It's a little disappointing. So, obviously, we're going to go for the dig there, and this thing is going to try and paralyze me. And that shit is just not going to have an effect. And I'm hoping this dig will bring it down. I don't think it will, but it's going to do a huge amount of damage regardless. It's going to continue to go for the glare. And that is still not going to hit. And I'm almost certain a double edge will bring it down at that health pool, so I'm just going to go for the double edge. I'm only losing 80 power. And yeah, that'll bring it down. It is, in fact, down and out. So Agatha, not even doing anything. Agatha proving to be weaker than Bruno, which is kind of funny. And her last Pokemon is, in fact, Venusaur, which is really funny. Unfortunately, my special did get lowered by that Psychic, so this probably won't do too much. Either way, though, that's going to do nearly half. But Venusaur, not messing around. It's going to go for the Sleep Powder there. And Derry is unconscious now. But I do have the ability to switch out, so I am going to take the opportunity to do that and switch out. We're going to go into Billy here, and I want to see what he's going to do. He's going to go for the Mega Drain, so that kind of sucks for me. Because that's going to do a huge amount of damage. Holy shit, that did like 100 damage. I'm actually going to go for the Amnesia here. I probably should have gone Thunder Wave. And it's going to go for Solar Beam. It is not messing around. I don't even know if this Amnesia is going to be able to protect me from this. Either way, it will go down on this next turn to a Psychic if I can survive the Solar Beam. Holy shit! And of course, it gets a fucking critical hit. And that is going to bring down Billy. I was worried about the critical. I'm pretty sure I would have lived the Solar Beam if it didn't critical. But of course, it does critical. And, you know, there's not much I can do about that. Either way, though, I still do have Excellent in this battle. And this thing is going to go for Double Edge, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage. That's going to do some decent recoil, though, to it as well. And Chansey's is going to go for the Ice Beam here. And it nearly brings it down. In fact, I think it will bring itself down on this next turn. So we'll see what happens. Nope, it's going to go for Mega Drain. It knows that it can no longer double-team, or double-edge. And as you can see, that does nothing to me. And Excellent is going to be able to finish this thing off. So down goes Venusaur, and down goes Agatha. Down goes Frazier. So just like that, we're already on the last trainer of the Elite Four. But of course, the best is last. And we'll see if we can defeat Lance. Of course, Lance, the most badass trainer in any Pokemon game. I mean, the guy has a cape, for God's sake. That's incredible. And I'm noticing that he doesn't have Dragonite. What the tits? What? Why does he not have Dragonite? Is this for real? This has got to be a joke, right? Wow. I guess it feels the Dragonite is like too... But it has Charizard. That is incredibly stupid, and I'm very disappointed right now, but oh well, there's not much I can do about it. So, looking at this team, I think the best lead's going to be Pope. I think we'll bring in Billy just to be safe. And I think we'll go with Solomon as well. So it's kind of funny that Lance doesn't use the Dragonite, but oh well. Ah, shit. Alright, well, he's going to lead with Snorlax, and this Snorlax is going to have a buttload of HP, over 500 HP. And we're just going to go for the EQ here, and we're going to see how much damage that can do. And oh my god. Oh, Jesus. This could be a problem. I'm just going to keep going for Earthquakes, though. This will be a solid 5-hit KO. Maybe in a 4-hit if something happens. But it continues to go for Amnesia. And that's going to be a problem at some point. But not now, because he's not attacking me. So we'll continue to go for Earthquake, doing as much damage as we possibly can. We do get a critical there, and that nearly brings it... that nearly brings it down. And it's going to finish off its special status raising, and it's a little too late because of that critical, so that kind of sucks for you, Lance, but that's what you get for getting greedy. You could have easily finished me off with whatever attack that you had, but you chose to continue raising your stats. I'm assuming you were going to go for rest following the third Amnesia, but... I'm sorry, that's just the way the cookie crumbles there, and now he's going into Kangaskhan, another normal type. So just like Giovanni, he is using both normal types and not even giving a fuck. He is, he's doing what he can. Continue to go for Earthquake, and we get another critical here, and this is pretty awesome with all these criticals. And the only thing this thing can do is Body Slam. And that is not very effective. He does, however, score the Paralyze, and I was a little afraid of that, but that's okay. He does have the Rock Slide. And that's going to do a huge amount of damage. Pope is not going to be flinched, though, and he is going to continue with these criticals. This is unbelievable. What kind of luck is this? You'll never see this. You will never see that happen. It's always the other way around, him getting all the criticals. This may bring me down, but it is not going to. I'm going to be able to live with 18 HP. Will it matter? Yes, it will. That means I can finish him off. And just like that, Lance is down to his last Pokemon. His last Pokemon is Charizard. It's unfortunate that I am paralyzed, because I could easily bring this thing down in one hit with a Rock Slide, but it's just going to go for Seismic Toss. And that's going to bring down Pope. And indeed, a Light Tap is going to decide the outcome there. I'm assuming Charizard has Dig and some other attack that's going to do damage. But we are looking good here. I think we're going to be able to take this guy out. We can either go with Thunderbolt or Surf, but I'd rather get the stab, so we're going to go for Thunderbolt. And that's going to do a huge amount of damage. It actually has Earthquake. And that's going to do a huge amount of damage. So a lot of power going out here. But this will do it. And that's going to do it for the Elite Four. With the final strike there. Brings down Charizard. I would have rather that be Dragonite, but whatever. I don't understand why they didn't give him Dragonite. I think that's incredibly stupid. And I'm a little disappointed. But, oh well. You can't have everything, I guess. Anyway, that's it for the Elite Four. Elite Four battle clear! So, next time... we'll do the same thing that we did last time. We receive the key from the Elite Four and open the gate to the upper floor. Next time, we'll take on the rival. I will see you guys then.